welcome to Gardenville.tv. Here we are at Bloom 2011 in Phoenix Park, and it is just action all day here, and it's fantastic weather, isn't it? I'm joined here by Fraser McDonough from Rock and Waterscapes and Billy Alexander from Kells Bay Gardens. Now, you've come together, you've produced this wonderful, unusual garden. Can you tell us about what you have here today?
Kells Bay Gardens is down near Carrasabeen on the Ring of Kerry, and I'm the owner of it for the last few years, and myself and Fraser decided we'd come together to try and get some of the aspects that our gardens are well known for, such as the walled garden and the primeval forest, and bring it together in the display here in Bloom.
So for somebody coming in here now, would they recognise the various planting you have here? You have a huge collection of unusual plants.
Well, there'd be a lot of very rare stuff.
Yeah.
Then there'll be generic terms such as a tree fern, which a lot of people would be familiar with. But a lot of these species would be very rare and would thrive down in Kerry with the Gulf Stream, even despite the recent bad winters.
Oh, that's very interesting.
It is. I have seen, I think it's in, can't remember exactly, Castle Haven, there was some of that little valley which is gone native.
Yes.
Are they the ordinary Dicksonia and Carpidus that everyone's generally familiar with? Because when people hear from the garden centre, they ask for tree fern, and the chances are that's what they get.
Dicksonia and Carpidus.
And the poor things are put in all sorts of unsuitable situations.
Yes, but people love them for their architectural beauty.
Yeah.
Can you explain a little bit about your garden, how you came up with this design?
Well, we have the water feature here, which is Fraser's area of expertise, because there's a lot of water in the garden. We have the sound of the water, and we have all the ferns and the variety of ferns. It's a very tranquil setting. Most people like it because they just feel it's very natural. The garden shells are very natural. They've naturalised over 150 years of the same plants growing there.
So just talk something about the plants here, Susan. I have absolutely no idea about
we're
planting.
We're surrounded by ferns, and I'm slightly out of my depth. Most people, talk about tree ferns, Dicksonia and Carpidus. But Billy's been coming because there are loads here, a lot from the southern hemisphere, you say.
Yes, that's right.
And unusual, but suitable for the climate in Kerry.
Yes, well,
and that sort of moist, warm.
Fern is a very resilient plant, and what we're trying to show is the variety. Like, you have red foliage in some of the ferns
there.
You have big, bold foliage here.
And this one here?
Yes.
Yeah.
Then you have polypodiums. This is a North American one, which is more arid. But you would find that most of them come together and are very happy in the Irish climate.
Very interesting. It is lovely.
And then you've put trees in between. You've interspersed with trees then around. What are these big ferns here at the back? You see on the border against your wall?
They're Dicksonia fibrosa. They come from New Zealand. They would be a lot rarer than the Antarctica, Dicksonia Antarctica, which most people have.
And they grow really without any problem now down around Kerry.
Yes, despite the recent winters, it was very challenging. Yeah. But yes, down in Kerry, they do very well.
And I love the ones which are actually growing in the water. Is that southern hemisphere again?
Once again, yes, they come from South Africa, Tasmania, Australia and New Zealand. And it's a Todia barbara. And it's actually happier with its feet in water. And they thrive marginally at the edge.
Fantastic. I just think this is so natural. I mean, really, you could have walked into a piece of the bay, for instance, or into any piece of sort of woodland down in Kerry.
Yes.
And is this where your expertise
comes
in, Fraser? Can you explain your water feature here?
Yeah, well, we specialise in natural, mystic-looking water features at Rock and Waterscapes, and what we wanted to achieve here was totally natural-looking aged rocks, aged sort of wood, logs, to make the water feature look as natural as possible. So each rock here was individually picked out to create the waterfall and stream area.
This is coming down, this little channel here, coming down into the pond.
Into the pond,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
With a three-tiered waterfall there for the sight, for the movement, sound, as you get down in Kells Bay. And we've dyed the water sort of a peaty brown colour.
Yes, you get that through.
Yeah.
You absolutely feel you're in the middle of
somewhere. Just
to,
exactly as in Kells Bay.
Yeah.
The streams that come through the gardens and mix with other streams and waterfalls, they're collecting a lot of the soil and the sort of peat soil, and it's dyed that sort of bronze colour.
And there is an art to placing rock, and you're probably putting them in, walking away, coming back, moving the thing.
There is a lot of
and
that. Yes,
hours.
And
hours. Really
yes.
Yeah.
You're never happy.
You're never happy, and then you go away, and then
you go away, and you move
and
it, and yeah. Yes, and you want to make sure that on each of the falls that the rock.
Yeah.
The water flows over the rock naturally, mm-hmm. and it's not man-made looking like
steps and stairs.
Yeah,
yeah,
so as you see,
your,
or
yeah,
a sheet of slate or something
yes,
like that.
It just
takes away the total naturalness mm-hmm. of the whole thing.
Your edging around this is absolutely fantastic. You've covered it in moss, isn't it?
Yes, there
yeah.
is.
I picked those pieces out from the gardens last week. So these are interspersed around the gardens over many decades of plants that have fallen down naturally and been cut down, and they moss up like that. You know, that is quite hard to replicate,
yeah.
to be honest.
Yeah.
But that is in abundance down in Kells.
Oh, right. Absolutely.
I think it is. Yeah. I think it's great.
And again, we have a few rocks interspersed yeah. with it. Some of the natural grass is hanging mm-hmm. over the side just to create the natural
great.
Effect. The biggest mistake you make is rocks all around, like what they call the necklace effect.
Yeah. Oh,
totally,
right,
totally unnatural.
Absolutely.
In the
yeah, no, it's absolutely terrific. And many thanks to Fraser McDonough from
Thank you very
Rock
much.
And Waterscapes.
That's correct, yes.
And to Billy Alexander from Kells Bay Gardens.
And could I just add
sure.
that these gardens are open to the public every day from 10 to 5, and there's accommodation available now. Overlooking
oh.
Dingle Bay, your bedrooms with nice views.
Oh, you must
Brilliant.
Tell us about that before we finish up here,
right.
about the accommodation.
The accommodation is 4-star. It's just really renovated in a Victorian building. There's 3 separate apartments, 2 beds and 1 bed. And the main house will be coming on stream for bed and breakfast hopefully next year.
So, Billy, how can somebody make a booking with you at Kells Bay?
Well, they can either phone me on my mobile, which is on the website, or they can send me an email, and hopefully we'll have a slot for them, and we'd love to see as many as possible.
Absolutely.
But for this project, Kells Bay, to survive, we need visitors coming down to visit the gardens, having a cup of tea, having a meal, and enjoying the ambiance that this garden has to offer.
And there's a big Irish welcome for
them. Absolutely. There's a big Irish hairy kingdom welcome.
Absolutely. So for anybody who might be looking at this from America, because we get a lot of tips
yes.
on gardenville.tv from
yes.
around the world,
yes.
how can they make a booking with you?
Send me an email.
What's your email address?
It's info@kellsgardens.ie.
Yeah.
And we're right in between world-class golf courses in Waterville and Duke's Golf Club.
Oh.
So
yeah.
it's a paradise.
Any golfing guy now, he could go play the golf and then go into the tranquil yeah. setting of
yes.
your gardens and stay with you at the
yes.
same time. Have you a website?
I do.
Yeah?
It's kellsgardens.ie.
Great. Well, Billy Alexander from Kells Bay Gardens, many thanks. And again, Fraser McDonough, Rock and Waterscapes. Thank you for talking to us on Gardenville.tv.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Well done.
Great.